Hello everybody, this is Pranay again. Today we are going to discuss a word question which you all might be wondering for a long time and could not reach to a conclusion. To help us on that, we have Mr. Manish Kumar again.
Hello.
So he'll probably give us insight on that question. Along with that, we have a couple of other questions which we got on website. We'll come to that later. So welcome Manish, first of all.
Thank you.
The very first question that any parent, at least in Middle East or who is living abroad, who is an NRI, wonder about DASA, is it worth it?
Right.
What's your thought?
Let me not put it in this way, in a very certain way, where I say that, you know, based on my experience, you should go for whether DASA worth of it or it's not worth of it.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Let me present some facts to you, so that on the basis of that, you parents and students can decide whether it is worth of it. Talking about DASA and CIWG, NRI programs, which is like a lifeline for all the students and parents who are living abroad, so that they can seek admission to NITs, other centrally funded institutions in India,
right. Okay,
for engineering programs and some other different programs.
Yeah.
So before we proceed further, let me put a case to all of you.
Right.
It's a very classic case and will give all of us a very good insight. The name of the student is Sandra. She is a perfect scorer of 24 and 24. She has lived in UAE and she has been a student for the last 12
years. Oh, yeah.
At present, she is doing computer science with NIT Varanasi.
Okay.
So 2 days back, I had a call from her father, Mr. Sebastian. And what he said that at present, Sandra is struggling with, you know, some concepts, especially in engineering and some mathematics.
Mm-hmm.
She's also trying to come to terms with, you know, that new learning that she has found out in NIT.
Has been new to her.
Well, definitely, all the things are new to her.
Right.
She has been brought up in UAE. And apart from that, you know, he was also talking about the hostel and the peer groups and all
this. Right.
So the case is that Sandra, she is a perfect scorer of 24 and 2400.
Right.
Uh-huh. She also cracked JE. Right. Ultimately, she had to make a choice whether she would be taking an IIT route through JE or through DASA CIWG program. So definitely through JE, she was not getting a good NIT and she always wanted to go to the top 5 NITs.
Okay.
NIT Varanasi is one of them.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, she was a perfect scorer. So
right.
It was an ideal choice for her. She was accepted in the CIWG program in the first round of counseling.
Yeah.
And she is doing that, all set for that.
Right.
So, you know, if we think about the matrix, which is, you know, which on the basis of this, we can decide whether DASA CIWG is worth of it or not.
Right.
Right. The matrix is of what? It's of 4 components, especially.
So it's going to be like the key points that we are
key
going.
Points, you know, that okay. We can discuss. It's about financial components,
right.
Social, cultural, and psychological.
Okay.
Of course, you know, intention just to put up the case of Sandra was just to let you know as what actually are the things, you know, she's undergoing.
Mm-hmm.
So definitely, you know, she's falling within this matrix.
Right, right.
The social, cultural, and psychological.
Okay.
So now, when we talk about the financial aspect of this, there are 2-3 things.
Right.
First of all, if you see the fee, I mean, you are living in Middle East.
Right.
And if someone wants to send his child to say US, Canada, Singapore, etc.
Right, right.
Right. So the fee at present, you know, under DASA and CIWG quota,
mm-hmm.
At present, today it is 8th of September 2020, the fee under CIWG quota is 5 lakh Indian rupees for a 4-year degree of BTEC or
degree. Right.
Right. And under DASA quota, it's 21 lakh Indian rupees
right.
for a 4-year degree of BTEC.
Okay. So roughly I have a similar question coming up on the website. If you don't mind, I want to pick it up so that if a user is viewing
it
properly,
we can synchronize
it. It's actually related to it.
Yeah.
So he's writing, I was looking at university fee structure, other university fee structures also.
Yeah.
Like NTU, do you think $7,000 is justified?
Well, when we are thinking about actually a child's education, we must not see it from investment and return point of view, because this is a subjective thing, you know? It's not a certain thing.
Okay.
As I told you that there are a lot of other deciding factors. So let's talk about, I mean, first of all, let's compare the fee of DASA CIWG quota to that of the fee in US, Canada, and Singapore universities.
Right.
Right. in any, I mean, even in most city in US, you know, which is in the second line, okay, the fee is not less than 60 lakh Indian rupees for 4 years.
Right, right.
So it is completely, you know, three times to CIWG and DASA.
Okay.
I would also like to mention over here that Government of India, MHRD, they are working out a fee structure, especially for CIWG, Children of Indian Workers in Ghana.
Okay.
So last year in 2017 intake, it was, you know, what the MHRD did, they made it at par with the DASA quota, which was 21 lakh.
Right.
A lot of people, they appealed to MHRD and they were kind enough just to bring down the fee to 5 lakh.
I remember.
So today the scenario is this, but I'm quite sure that looking into all these things in order to give a certainty point of view, the Government of India would definitely like to, you know, work out this fee, maybe not 21 lakh, maybe 21 lakh, maybe 10 lakh or whatever it is. That we would be able to know once the brochure of DASA CIWG on this
is circulated.
Yeah, once it is circulated in 2008. That would be, I think, the beginning of April. We'll see that. But nothing to worry. In any case, it's not going beyond 21 lakh. Okay,
yes.
Then if it is made at par with DASA.
Right.
So this was about, you know, the second line of universities in the US, that would be that you have to pay 60 lakh. So, what, and nowadays, you know,
for a UG course you are talking about?
Yeah, I'm talking about the undergrad engineering courses for 4 years. If you are going to top line universities like Harvard, Stanford, Yale and MIT, you know, if you do not win a scholarship, then the fee is definitely approximately 1 crore Indian rupees for a 4 year degree. It's completely up to you how you work out. That's quite high. Now, second thing is that if you see the quality of education here in NITs, you know, in India and other CFIs, it is really much better. It's rigorous, you know. And you parents, you definitely must have realized if you are engineers, you know, what type of quality of education you got.
Okay. Yeah.
So the ideal channel is that a child does its his or her undergrad course from NITs or other CFIs in India through DASA and CIWG quota.
Right.
And then he takes, you know, GRE, GMAT or GAT route, you know, if you want to go to IIITs, PG courses, if you want to go to US, to US, Canada, and all these places.
Right.
Similarly, the fee in National University of Singapore and NTU, you know, is also exorbitant.
Right.
It's completely up to you. Right. Now, another thing is that if you see the, you know, the infrastructure and the infrastructure cost of NITs in India. Each year, the Government of India gives 180 to 200 crore to each of the NITs in India.
Okay.
And the fee under DASA quota is, you know, 20 lakh. So in order to maintain that infrastructure, government requires to have an intake of at least 1,000 students to maintain that. So that's, you know, also very, very important.
Is government spending a lot more than what you pay?
Right. So apart from that, you know, now there is another opportunity which is looked after by the parents in Middle East or all over. There are many private universities in India, in different parts of India. Even if you go to these private universities, I mean, which are definitely private universities or any university, they do not give any sort of guarantee, or definitely they don't have the brand name of NITs, National Institute of Technology, or IIIT, Institute of Information Technology. These premier, you know, elite institutions over there, the fees more than, you know, 20 lakh,
right.
25 lakh, 30 lakh, right, for the same 4 year degree or B.A.
Okay.
So now I think based on my analysis of these financial aspects, your parents and students can definitely think that DASA is worth it.
So it's always better to go through this channel than rather
than this. Quite legitimate. This is these are all government premier elite institutions. You have got very good infrastructure. All learned professor, you know, an environment that lets you know, lets you smell your opportunity. You know, well, I mean, not necessarily once you go to these NIT or other CFIs, you think that, okay, you have to become a hardcore engineer,
right?
I mean, there are a lot of things. I mean, this is the culture in NITs, IITs and other CFIs. Because most of them, their aspirational index is very high.
Right.
So, you know, I have seen many students who have lived in Middle East, but they cracked UPSC and their ISIPs.
Yes.
Right. They didn't want to go for business, but having got into NITs, you know, where there's a culture of group study, where all students, they flow together and
right.
they divide themselves into a group. You know, the culture is that you're defining two to three groups. One group is that would always like to go to the startup.
Right.
Another group of the student is that would like to go for UPSC or in PSC.
So there are divisions amongst them.
Right. And one group is that they would like to fly to US having written GI and GMAT.
Right.
So, you know, you get an atmosphere at all these places. So this is not something that we are going to get anywhere else. That's it.
Okay, so we have another question here.
Yeah.
Since you've answered it very well, I think most of the parents will definitely agree to it.
Yeah.
Another question is, one parent has asked, how good NITs placement and academics are? Because I think that's a genuine question they would ask before spending this much of money.
I think NITs and other CFIs, you know, they are like factories to provide talent to the best of the multinationals and all over the world.
Mm-hmm.
Right? I did not tell you about the world-renowned persons who have created organizations who are at different places,
mm-hmm.
where they have created a niche for themselves.
Right. Right.
So, placement definitely is not a problem at NITs. So you have got all full of opportunity. As I told you,
mm-hmm.
after doing your BTEC, you can go to US, you know, have you written GRE and GMAT, or if you want to go for corporate research, or want to join PSUs, which give you very lucrative, you know, amount
mm-hmm.
as a salary and a very secure future. You know, you can join PSU public sector undertaking.
Okay.
You can even go to the government jobs, like elite government jobs like UPSC, IAS, IPS, IFS, IRS, and all these. And apart from that, you know, the government has also formed many equipment, you know, cells in
mm-hmm.
these NITs and other places where you can have your own startups, so
right,
you are respected
right.
for your ideas.
Right.
And if you are looking at it from a simple point of view, where the companies are coming to the campus and
the campus placement,
hiring the student, of course that's not a problem. Try to understand it. So these are NITs.
So
and
this is a regular thing. People
CFI.
Tend to
yeah.
do
yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
separate things, right?
Definitely. You belong to the premier elite institutions of India. There are all together 76, and India is full of opportunity. Even if you live in India, I would love it because you have your country.
Right.
Even if you go to US, so it's a win-win situation just to you know, get into NITs and other CFIs. So placement should not be a problem.
Right. Okay, that's good. So another satisfying answer maybe for the parents, but other thing that we usually come across, and that's a common question asked by the parents. Getting again 24 on 2400, is this the way out? Because if they get 2100 or 2200 or maybe 2000, parents do ask, will we be able to make it to NIT? Will we be able to get a desired stream?
Oh, it's not that the world will become upside down if you do not get 24 and 24. You still have got very good opportunity. But of course, you know, as a parent and as a student, you need to understand
mm-hmm.
what actually is taking you to NITs and all these places. No doubt that the competition is getting higher day by day, because there are a lot of students, you know, as I told you in the beginning, that NIT, I mean these DASA and CIWG and SATI, it's like the best buzzwords as well as the lifeline for all the students and the parent community being all over the world, especially in the Middle East, right? So getting 24 and 24 in there, I mean, I have seen that most of the students who come to the test prep part, they get 24 and 24 in
uh-huh.
because they have got a complete ecosystem for
right.
SAT subject test.
That's
right.
Structure.
So, you know, even if you don't get 2400, you must know that last year, in 2017 intake,
mm-hmm.
the minimum cutoff which for SAT subject test, which was of 1440,
yeah,
it was
yeah.
raised up to 1800.
Yeah, right.
No doubt that in, no surprises if in 2018 intake it has been made up to 2100 or something, because this is competition.
This is a possibility of
everyone wants to go to these, you know, institutions. So keep yourself ready, right? And it's possible.
Mm-hmm.
If I say that you know, a day would come where all seats under DASA and CIWG, they have been taken for 2400, right? I won't be surprised.
I think
you'll see in in JE from 2018 JE, you know, you will have 54 questions to
Right.
So the way you attempt these questions and the nature of these questions are completely different. It's subjective.
Right.
Whereas in SAT 2, you know, in physics you get 75 questions, in chemistry you get 85 questions of different nature. In math you get a straightforward 50 questions.
Yeah, so I think on structure we have a
right.
different VU. I'll
so and the time limit is 1 hour.
Okay. Yes.
So even if you do not answer some of the questions in, I mean, at least 10 questions in physics and chemistry, So still you are able to get perfect score 24 and 24. So this actually the beauty of a SAT subject test that gives you a score. Even if you don't know something, you are supposed to be the best. So I think it's a win-win situation for you. I mean, you should always try to work hard and I mean, with something like, you know, a spiral ascendancy, you do a lot of test papers and all these in a disciplined way. Getting 24 and 2400 is not an issue. It's not a problem. Of course, these NITs also have to maintain their standards. The Government of India is also thinking, you know, a lot about whether, you know, what should be the minimum cutoff of a SAT 2. So I'm sure that in near future, it's going to be more than 1800. Okay. Practically, whosoever wants to go to best of the NITs is the best of the schemes.
Right.
Should be ready with 24 and 24. That's all.
Okay. So we have an answer for that.
Yeah.
Right. So these were the limited questions that were coming to the website as of now.
Yeah.
What's your final conclusion for those parents who are willing to take their awards for the examination this year? What do you think about them? What's your final call for them? What's your conclusion for this question?
See, I'm always certain about this that you know. NITs and other CFIs, they have got a very good academic merit, very good infrastructure.
Okay.
And fee wise, we have already compared. So, I think it's 100 times worth it.
Okay. Okay. So, any message for the students who are preparing for SAT this year? Any special message to them?
I mean, a very simple thing that let's keep the thing simple, be disciplined, work hard. I mean, we are here just to solve all the queries as well as your academic thrust.
Yeah, that's it. Okay, so thank Manish for the wonderful insight on this.
Thank you.
And I would like to thank all of you for joining us today. And now we are ending up this discussion here itself. If you have any further query, please do email it to us on info@testprepcard.com or call us at 91-999-00-1864. You can email all your questions to us. We'll possibly try to take up those questions in next video. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.